Bimmian.com installation guide for the painted keyhole cover. In this installation guide, we're going to show you how to install the keyhole cover on an E90. Now, this installation is the exact same on an E92 and very similar to the E46, 1 Series, X3, and X5. The first thing you want to do is open your door so you can see this little rubber grommet that you see here. All you have to do to remove it is just with your fingernail, you just lift underneath it. It comes right off. On the E46, it may actually be like a little panel here. It's the same thing, you just lift it right off. Now, it's important to note, if you look inside this the little hole here, you'll see a solitary screw. So what you want to do, the only thing to remove your keyhole cover is to loosen this screw. So what we'll do is with a 5 32 Allen key, insert it inside the screw, just like so, and turning it counterclockwise, we loosen the screw here. Now, what I like to do is maintain a pressure pushing into the screw itself, because the last thing you want to do is have your screw fall into your door panel. So with that pressure, I just keep turning. And you can, at this point, you can wiggle the keyhole cover. You can see it's already becoming a little bit looser. So once you, I just like to wiggle it like this, just to figure out when the keyhole cover is actually loose from the screw. So giving a few more turns, you can see it's really starting to get loose now. Maintaining that lateral pressure on the screw. At this point, it feels pretty good. It feels like it's pretty loose. Now, on an E46, by just keeping wiggling on the keyhole cover, it'll actually come right out. On an E90, E92, it's a little bit different. It's a little more stubborn. What you need to do at this point is gently remove the Allen key and get a secondary tool, which are needle nose pliers. So what you want to do with the needle nose pliers is insert them inside and grab onto the screw. Now what you want to do here is actually pull out towards you a slight bit, making sure to maintain that pressure so it's not, you're not going to let go of the screw, it's going to fall inside your door panel. And you can actually feel that once you just pull it back a bit, the keyhole cover with a few wiggles comes right out just like that. Okay? And once you actually remove the keyhole cover, you'll see why you want to pull it out just a slight bit. And this, keep in mind, this is only for the E92. So you just remove your existing keyhole cover. Get your Bimmian.com painted keyhole cover, and at this point, the next step would be to remove the puddle lights from your OEM keyhole cover and install it into your Bimmian.com painted keyhole cover. This particular vehicle does not have puddle lights, so we don't have to worry about that step. Now, if your car doesn't have them, it's no problem. The keyhole cover still is identical. So at this point, what you want to do, keep in mind, if you're an E92 or E90, reach in, pull that screw back up just a little bit here, so your keyhole cover can slip in unimpeded. And once you feel that pressure, I can now gently remove my needle nose pliers, switch back to the Allen key, and reverse the process. Just simply insert that in, turning clockwise. And you can begin to feel the keyhole cover become tight. Remember, take your time. Make sure you keep that lateral pressure just in case the Allen key slips out of your hands. And you actually begin a few wiggles, you get to feel that that pressure. So there we go. I can start to feel it. It's actually tightening up now. It's now grabbed onto our new keyhole cover. You know, you have to be too rough with it. I can feel that's going to hold just fine. So I remove my Allen key gently. The last step of the process is to simply replace your rubber grommet. And we're done. Now, as you can see, the color of this car doesn't match the keyhole cover, but this is just to show you the contrast of what the part actually does. So that's the installation guide for today. We look forward to serving you again.